fell in a store in Carthage, Mississippi, and I didn't hurt that day. I hurt it later, maybe two or three days later, and I had gone back to the store, and I was letting them know, you know, that I had fallen. Well, they knew I fell, but they was like, well, you got back up and walked, so what do I need to do?
Hey, well, Nat, what caused you to fall?
I was going to ask the same thing.
There were three boxes in the floor that shouldn't have been in the floor. I tripped over.
There was something in the floor that shouldn't have been there?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
What would you tell Annette, Johnny?
Well, first of all, you need to consult an attorney. That's what typically is referred to as a slip and fall case.
Mm-hmm.
It's a premise liability case. You were injured on the premises of a business. You would be a invitee in that situation, and they have a duty to warn you of a dangerous condition or to prevent that dangerous condition from existing. One of the things in that situation that you're going to have to look at and hopefully prove is how long that stuff was in the floor where it shouldn't have been. Did they have notice? Should they have known it was there? And then did they fail to remove it in a timely manner? And if those things check out, then you can potentially hold them liable and recover for your injuries. The delay in injury, that's not an issue. That happens all the time with car wrecks and other type situations where you're not hurt right away, but the pain kind of gradually onsets over the few days after the accident.